Well, Scrappers, let me show you what we'll be doing today. I have two nice gold-plated pieces of metal. They're from old watches, Russian ones, and unfortunately they are not really good. They have probably at about 0.2 grams of gold, but a friend of mine gave me these two and asked me, please, can you take the gold out from them for me? So that's fine, it's really quick, and I'll do this for him. What is the first to do? I have to calculate how much acid I need to get rid of the base metal. So let me start the scale and let's check the weight of these two. So is it correct to say 25 grams? If this is 25 grams, this means that I will need at about 75 milliliters of nitric acid, 60%, to dissolve the base metal. 75 milliliters. Okay, let's go to the lab now. Hello guys, so we are in the lab. What we have here in the beaker? We have the two cases from watches and we have distilled water, 100 milliliters of distilled water. Actually, it's important to be distilled because if you add just tap water, you may have chlorine inside and you may dissolve part of your gold, which I'm sure you don't intend. What is the next step? We have to add nitric acid. As I said, we'll need at about 75 milliliters in total, but I'll not add 75 milliliters. I will add at about probably, we'll start with 50. Let's check how much I added exactly. There were 100 milliliters of distilled water and I added about 50 milliliters of 60% nitric acid. So reaction will slowly start. Now what's going on inside? Nitric acid is searching for some defects on top of the watches to start dissolving the base metal. Let's put glass watch on top and wait, because I expect this reaction from certain point onwards to start really quickly. Our gold. These are the gold foils from the two watch cases and I transfer them into this beaker. Now, what I have in this beaker? I have the gold plating and I have about 10 milliliters hydrochloric acid. What is the next step? Next step is to add some nitric acid and form aqua regia, but I will not rapidly add nitric acid. I know that I have really small amount of gold here, so I'll just add drops. It's about 1 milliliter, no more. And let's see what we'll get. I'll start the heating and let's see if we'll have this gold quickly dissolved. Pretty cold, winter is coming here, so let's wait on the hot plate for a while and see how quickly it will take this gold to dissolve. Just to show you, I just added another 1 milliliter, and look at this nice yellow color. It looks fantastic. Let's wait a little bit more and all our gold will be dissolved. We have had some copper hidden because the color changed a little. Obviously, we didn't manage to dissolve the base metal fully of the watch cases. But now, next step, filtering. I'll quickly filter this solution because there is also some dirt inside. And I will just use simple filter. I don't need vacuum or something like this, because this filtering will go really fast. But you have to be really careful, because if you don't well rinse the beaker, you may lose some gold. So no yellow on the filter, on the beaker. Everything has to be clear at the end. So what is the next step? We have to get rid of the nitric acid. I didn't put a lot, but we don't need it, because we have to correctly precipitate our gold. I'm adding urea, and you see, as I said, I added really low amount of nitric acid, because now urea reacts with the nitric acid and we have the denoxing, so-called, of the solution. We remove the nitric acid. Let's add some more. And when you do this, solution must be hot. Not boiling, but above 80 degrees Celsius, let's say, to be efficient. Let me add a little bit more, just to be sure. We removed all the nitric acid. And now it's time to precipitate the gold. I will use this time, like Dr. Blin, I will use iron sulfate, but I will not dissolve it, I will just add it with a spoon, like this. So let's see. That's how your gold recovery video turns to be gold recovery from dirty solutions. You see, when you have so dirty solution and you want to recover gold, let's add some more. Here we go. You see how we recovered the gold? This brown stuff is our gold. Let's add more. Here we go. And let's speed up a little. Increase the heating. Let's boil this solution. And let's see what we'll get at the bottom. Hopefully our gold. Now I'll cover it and heat it until it boils. Hopefully I'll see my gold on the bottom. I think I already see it. Let me move this. I see flying gold inside. Can you see it, guys? Yes. I definitely see gold on the bottom. Small gold pieces. Which is great. Let me add a little bit more, because I'm not sure, my scale is not around to check how much exactly I'm adding. So I'm trying to go at about 5-10 grams to be sure I'll fully precipitate this gold. Okay. Let's wait for it now to boil, and we'll check it at the end. That's our gold. If I get 0.2, I'll be really happy. These watches were not the best on the I've seen, so let's check what we have. I'll mail it now and I'll tell you the final result. Okay, scrappers, so that's the final result. Look at this shiny beauty. It's so yellowish and so nice. Let's check the weight. I'll put it here on the scale. 0.21. Let's check it one more time. 0.23. So at about 0.22, let's say, grams of really pure gold, looking at the color. Not bad, not bad. So 0.1 from each of these watches. That's not a lot, but it's from trash. So not bad. Keep scrapping and don't forget to recover your gold, guys. Bye.